going to take a drive out to Joshua Tree today, and I have my chair, I have a couple of cigars, I got a little libation, and I'm going to have a sunset and maybe some stars tonight. So I'm not sure how much I'm going to record, but I just wanted to take you along if you're interested in sharing my pleasant impromptu Zen evening with you. So as we leave, I'm not sure what we're in for, but I appreciate you being here. If you like what you see today, please subscribe to my channel. I'm trying to grow it, trying to be somewhat inspirational and try to motivate people to get out and have adventures. Enjoy this amazing world that we live in, because it's fantastic. I know there's a lot of negative things going on in the world right now, but I will not have a part of it. I am not going to let it affect me or how I live. Life is way too short, and I say it a lot. Life is too short for anything but joy. So I'm going to enjoy it. I'm going to enjoy my afternoon. I'm going to enjoy my sunset. I'm going to enjoy beautiful Joshua Tree National Park in the evening and stick around for some stars. So here we go. I think it's going to be a good afternoon. Entering Joshua Tree National Park at the south entrance, which leads you to the Cottonwood Visitor Center. It's the far south side of the park, and the reason we're going there is because Joshua Tree is listed as a Southern California dark spot, and this is the darkest spot in Joshua Tree. So if you want to go there, it's off the 10 freeway. And all you have to do is type Cottonwood Visitor Center, Joshua Tree, into your Waze or your Google Maps or Apple Maps. And it'll take you to this visitor center. And then what you do is you take the road that goes east right before you get to the visitor center. And you take it all the way to the end. And at the end of that road, there is not only a really nice trail called the Mastodon Peak Loop. It's 2 or 3 miles, but it's not too difficult, but it's really pretty. And there's also a spot, there's a little kind of a park bench over there where you can typically see some vultures and different wildlife. I've seen vultures, eagles, foxes, a coyote, lots of rabbits. It's a very peaceful spot, and not a lot of people go there because typically Joshua Tree visitors go to the popular places. They come in off the north entrances through Joshua Tree or 29 Palms. So you actually get to experience the beauty of Joshua Tree in this little area, take a hike, and experience some really dark skies. I like to take my little folding chair and sit out there with my camera and see if I can get some good pictures. That's so relaxing. And you're kind of away from civilization, from all the insanity that's happening in the world right now. So I just wanted to let you know, if you ever want to go out there, that's where I'm going. Cottonwood Visitor Center. The darkest spot in Joshua Tree are the Cottonwood campgrounds over there. So that's where we're going to be going today. This is the road that leads into the south side of Joshua Tree National Park. And what's a little bit cool about this this little road is as soon as you get off the freeway about a mile in, off to the left and right, this is all Bureau of Land Management area. So you can bring your RV out here and you can camp for free for several days. I don't know if it's 14 or what it is, but it's kind of neat. You can camp out here for free. And then I think at the end of your 2-week period or whatever that is, you just have to move your RV to a new spot. We are approaching the Cottonwood Springs Visitor Center. Now, just as a note, you don't have to pay to get into this area. It's actually before the toll area. Seems to be quite a few people here today. So you just make a right turn headed east on this little road right before the Visitor Center. And you go all the way to the end. So just walking off into the desert. It's beautiful out here. So peaceful. I know it's not only always the safest thing to do is take off on a not official trail, but you don't find many people out here. Ooh, that looks like a nasty, nasty sting if you get to fall into that thing. Got my camera with me too, hoping to catch some kind of wildlife out here, something really interesting to take a picture of. I always come prepared. Let's go up there. Ooh, you gotta be careful here too. Lots of prickly things. It's just stunning out here. The sky is so blue. Clouds are so white. Kind of looks like a big whale coming out of the rock. Neat. Just love the colors and the texture of the rock. It's almost like coral. There's a cactus growing right out of the side of the rock. Like medicine for the soul. There's some quail right over here, so I'm gonna try to sneak up on them. See if I can get a good picture. If I do, I'll post it above my head in a second. It's pretty isolated, and there's a nice straight shot to the sunset, so I'm hoping I get a good one tonight. Here's my little fortress of solitude. Like to come out here. I got a couple of stogies I'm gonna fire up. Nobody around. Just perfect. So hopefully it'll be a good sunset tonight. Thanks for coming with me. Wow, this has been a spectacular evening. I've got my camera set up over there to to record the stars. You probably can't see diddly squat. So this is Elvis Boy. Just want to say again, cast aside the negative things in your life, the bad things, the things that make you sad, because there's no time for that. Just live in the moment. A moment just like this can change your life. And I just have to reiterate how important it is right now in this world to stop and smell the roses. I know it's an overused phrase, but it's so true. My goodness. You know, what I believe is the moment is when the past and the future are irrelevant. And it's so true, because they are irrelevant. The past is in the past. The future hasn't happened yet. Just live in the now. Find moments. Find ways to have a now moment. The more we can do that, the more happiness and joy we have inside. But if you've enjoyed this video at all, please subscribe to my channel. Share it. Like this video. And I promise you I'll make more just like this. If you know somebody that's overrun with stress, that's older, and thinks that life is not good, please share this video, because it can be. Tonight was absolutely spectacular, and I am genuinely happy. I'm genuinely at peace, and I've had a lot of things go not perfect in my life, and Lord knows we all, when we get to a certain age, we've accumulated a list of imperfections and mistakes a mile long. But I would just encourage you to get out and make moments, live in the now, watch a sunset, sit at home, and just live in the now. You don't have to get out here, but just stop stressing. The world is still a beautiful place. So, this is Elvis Boy for Into the Sunset, signing out. If you like this video, please share it. Subscribe. Love you guys, and I'll see you in my next video.